Welcome to class. I hope that you're getting a chance to take a look at everything. In the OneNote, you have this from the overview for this week, and you can read through it, see what we're going to do. I just want to talk about how to complete the practice that I'm asking you to do this week. So if I look down in the online engagement piece, there's going to be the video link to this video right here that I'm making right now. But if I click on this part, here's the link for creating the rectangles. This is the tool I want you to use while we're doing this. So I'm going to bring that up, and it's going to look like this. And I want you to click over here on algebra tiles. So we have some algebra tiles over here. So I'm going to do three examples of the type of thing that I want you to do. So notice that on this first one, it says x squared plus 5x plus 4, like four ones. So let's see. I have 1x squared, so I'm going to put 1x squared over here. I have 5x's, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's my 5x. Plus 4, 4 ones. So here's a 1 right here. So bring in these 4 ones, 1, 2, 3, 4. And now what I want you to do is take all of these and put them together, arrange them so they make a rectangle. And so if you'll notice, the x squared, it's called an x squared because this is x long, and x by x is x squared. This is an x because it's x by 1, so it's an x. And this is a 1 by 1, which is a 1. So I have an x squared, 5x's, 4 ones, and I want to arrange them into a rectangle. And if you'll notice, they kind of clip together like that. Now, when you put things together, make sure you put them together edge to edge like that. Like if I try to put this here, it's not going to work. These don't fit. They don't cover it up exactly. And even if I try to put a 1 in there, see how it's a little bit further. So I'm going to have to set them up edge to edge. So if I just do this, I've made a rectangle, but I didn't use my ones. My ones are left over. You know, so if I just try and like stack these in here somehow, let's say I do this, I'm not making a rectangle. This whole shape has to be a rectangle. So what you can see is, like in this case, I might need some that are these are up and down like this. I might need some of these that are more horizontal. So if I double click them, it'll rotate them. So double click them and it'll rotate them. So maybe if I put a couple of these like this, see how now I'm starting to get the shape of a rectangle here. That doesn't work. I have a hole here. How about if I take this and put it up here? Yeah, nice. Okay, so that works. So here is my here's my rectangle for this first one. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to come down here and use my snip and sketch. So I'm going to choose snip and sketch. That'll take a picture of the screen like this. And then if I take this cropping tool, image crop, I can just grab just a picture of the thing I made. Yeah, that's what I want. Copy it. It might automatically copy it. I don't know. And then I would just paste it onto my sheet here. And there's one more thing that I want to add to this. And that is, I'm going to rewrite this in a certain way. I'm just going to look at the dimensions of this thing, like this side length and this side length. And now what I'm looking at is just the side length here. So this distance right here, that's an X. So this is an X. And then each of these, I know that these blocks are X's, but this length is actually just a 1. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4. See how that's 4 long? So this side is X plus 4. And this side, there's an X. And again, this is just a 1, 1 long, X plus 1. So I'm going to rewrite this as X plus 4 times X plus 1. And that's what my answer will look like. You don't need to draw all this stuff here. But I do want a picture of it and it written this way. And notice when I have the x plus 4 times x plus 1, I'm figuring out what the area of this is. This length is x plus 4. This width is x plus 1. Length times width gives me that area. And talk a little bit more about this next week. But what I'm showing is, if I have x squared plus 5x plus 4, that's all the little individual pieces in here, I can rearrange them into a rectangle that has these dimensions, x plus 4 by x plus 1. In other words, x plus 4 times x plus 1 is equal to that. Those are two, they're equivalent, two different ways to write the same thing. All right, let's do the next two examples here. So I'm going to split this out. I have an x squared plus a 6x plus an 8. So I already have the x squared. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I need three more of these. 6. Oh, no. Just one more of those because there's only 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 8 ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right. So same game. I want to arrange this into some sort of rectangle. So thinking about how to do that. You know, I know that these down here are going to, these ones are going to have to arrange into a rectangle themselves. So I wonder if I did something like, no, that won't work. And really, like, it's just a puzzle, so I'm trying to think about how I could move stuff around. Maybe like that. Oh, that works. Nice. So I can think about moving this around. I can also start to think about, you know, if I have 8 of these, how can I arrange these ones, these 8 ones, into some sort of a rectangle so that my 6 x's fit along the outside of it? Well, there's my answer. So again, I'm going to do the Windows Ink Space, snip and sketch that. I want to crop it. That's what I want. Probably already saves it to paste that in there. And then let me think about this. This is x. This is 4. So one of my sides is x plus 4. This is x. This is 2. So my other side is x plus 2. So this is my area form. This is it in what's called factored form. But there we go. Okay, last one. X squared plus 7x plus 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need one more of these. And I have 8 of these, so I'll need 2 more ones. I have 1x squared. I have 7 x's. And I have 10 ones. Okay. So if I think about this 10, if I have 10 ones, if I want to arrange it into a rectangle, 10. It could be 1 by 10, and I could line them all up really straight like that. Or it could be kind of like a 2 by 5, maybe. So see how I have this lined up, x squared in the top right, the 1's in the bottom. And let me see if this works. I wonder if this will fill in. Yeah, that works. Nice. All right. Snip and sketch that piece. Crop it. Control V to paste it in there. Ha! Move it out of there. Maybe I'll just delete it and get below this. And there we go. And if I think about these side lengths, that's an x. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 5 long, right? 5 ones. That's an x. And 2 ones. So this factors to that. All right, so that is the practice I'd like you to get in this week on this sheet. Just do like what I was doing. Insert the picture. If it's too big or something, you know, you can resize it. And then, so two things, insert the picture puzzle that you've done from this page, and then also write it out like that. If you want to print it out and do it all by hand and then draw this over and over again, you know, you can do that too. That's absolutely fine. All right, send me an email, message me if you have any questions. I miss seeing y'all every day, and I hope this goes well for you.